Oh, now she can have identification 4 times, okay. Well, it's been a while since I've had her at full, I guess? Alright, probably nothing but this. That's a knife, right? Not the dagger. Let's check the hat, because I'm not sure about that. Just a hat. Shield 1. Yeah. Alright, this is the knife. Someone else is holding the dagger. The dagger is nothing as well, so. The knife. Just a regular knife. And I don't know if things can slip past us like that. It would probably just sell for a lot at the vendor. But I'm not sure about that. It's just regular stuff. Okay. So we have over 3,000 gold now. This is very awesome. And we have stuff to sell as well. So we're going to have even more gold shortly. Now what I did, I forgot, Gribben, I forgot to get him the crossbow bolts. That's one thing I forgot to do in Ilion. Do we get out of here again? Okay. Oh, I want to... I don't feel like switching the food around. This is how we waste money, by the way. Oh, the reception thing is over here. See that? Over 3,000. It's 150 gold. No matter who chooses it, I guess. Just so she can have all her magic points back. Okay. So we slept twice, we burned 300 gold. What are you gonna do? I'm sure... This seems like the kind of game where eventually you have more money than you know what to do with. And unfortunately, money can weigh you down in this game, so you end up buying jewels because you don't want to just throw money on the ground or whatever. We are here. I think the merchant is there. I'm thinking of the wrong town. Where are we? That is a merchandise. Okay, good. Make sure to have him selected. Probably doesn't make that much of a difference. He's got room. Let him sell the dagger. I'm gonna get some more of those rings. Those 1 or 3 AC rings, especially. We will sell things! Turn thing into money. See, he won't buy the signet ring. 115 gold for the dagger, not bad. 18 only gold for the knife. So a dagger is much better than a knife, see that? It's a special hat. Everyone's got a hat, right? I didn't make a lot of money, but... I just want to make sure no one's missing a hat or a helm of some kind. We bought the hats from... what's her name? With the cat named Felix. Three gold. Give me my three gold, damn it. Okay, now I gotta look through these spells. These scrolls, rather. And see if I want to memorize them, because they're taking up a lot of our slots. Satine especially, so... yeah, I'll be right back. Why, whatever are we doing here in the Tower of Grey Wizards? Well, I didn't realize that Satine can level up. I don't know how I didn't realize that. She levels up, according to my notes, at 3150. So, I'm guessing she's been over that amount for quite a while, and I just haven't realized. It goes back out, I'm thinking. One of these two. Are these open, like, certain hours? Because this is late right now. Reception. 8 o'clock. I think this is the library where you buy scrolls. I have to wait till 8 o'clock. Yes, I can't believe that. I must have just... not even realized. So, I figure, let's just come here. Rather than, you know, because we're going to improve her use magic scroll, or read magic scroll, I believe. Because she's close to being maxed out on her use magic. Now we can afford crap like this. Alright, Satine. Use magic is at 88, yeah. Can't go any higher, so... there we go. Ta-da! Level 9! Level 9? I had her down... that's to reach level... okay, right, right, I already changed this. So to reach level 10, we need 3850. And I have a lot less gold because I just bought 60 more rations. So basically, yeah, 10 for all of us and split us among us. Split it among us. Bloop. Okay, so now... she's level 9. And she's not too far away from the next level either. So we can't rest in here, right? So... I took some water damage. Not sure if we can rest out in the tunnels. We can. Alright, so I'm gonna take a look at all this crap that we have, and I'll be back. Okay, just want to show you guys what I'm doing. I'm in the middle of going back to Twin Lake, because that's that mine, that dwarven mine is near there. And I wrote it down, I think, west of there? Or east, sorry. I meant east, thinking of it on the map. Dwarass Mine. So I'm guessing, pretty sure that the, we'll be able to tell the puzzle mouth then will be Sarod, S-A-R-O-D. Anyway, so Dwarass Mine, this is a volcano valley east of Twin Lake. So I'm headed back to Twin Lake. I'm gonna sell these extra spells. Going to sell Beam of Fire, only does a point or two of damage, not worth it. Light 2, only Satine can know the spell, and will still can cast it from a, what do you call it? A scroll, but I think we have something else that can give off light as well. So This is fire. Wand of light, yeah. So. That casts light 3 and has 25 charges. So there's so many people can use it, actually. Anyway, so, yeah. Those are not needed. Definitely don't need the two light 2. And yeah, beam of fire, stinky, magic arrows, Transric already has it, I hardly ever use it. Actually, I'm curious here. It does a small amount of damage, if I can get my cursor out of here. Black magic. What's it? Arrows? Magic arrows? Magic arrows, he does a, oh, does a 8 damage, whereas fireball does 4 to 8, huh, well fireball is party wide, the magic arrows is just against a single target, oh, maybe not, G for group. A group of mods. Maybe I should be using magic arrows more often. It always does that much. Does it take more? Gray magic, white magic. Just looking at this. It takes 18 spell points. It takes more spell points than fireball. Anyway, so, yeah. He has the spell already. Maybe I'll have him start using it more often. Sleep. Amethyst knows that. Waterhole. Trasric knows it. And Mud Catapult. Trasric knows it. So we're selling all those. And it's still really irritating to get her to learn spells. I've been traveling a little bit. It seems it's keyed to either the clock or where you are on the map traveling. I think it's keyed to the clock, is what it is. It's a randomized number keyed to the clock. So if you basically stay in the same place the entire time, you're gonna fail every time. Just, if you fail, move a little, try again. But she is still horrible. She's at 25% to read magic, so basically 3 out of 4 times she will fail. And I try, actually took me 10 times at least to have her memorize Remove Curse, which is the first one. I'm like, damn. But now she knows Remove Curse, Blind, Irritation, and Fear. The rest have been here already. So pretty good. And she still has, every time you learn a spell, you use up spell learning points, so she still has 46. So she knows a good amount of her spells already. There's not too many more white magic spells. I mean, of course, we've got healing 4 and 5. Salvation, which is weird, because salvation, it says heals 4 to 20 life points, but that's exactly the same as healing 3. I wonder if that's a mistake in the manual, or it's just, I don't know, a fancy name for something you will find. Does the same thing. We have reincarnation, which is reincarnation of a body. Conversion of ashes, which reincarnates a burned body. Conversion of dust, which reincarnates a pulverized body. And this is not a walkthrough I'm looking at here, guys. This is the PDF of the actual manual here. So I think she has heal sickness. Rejuvenation, she doesn't have that one yet. Deep petrification, no. I think she might have wake up. So she has remove irritation. Yeah, I want her to know all this stuff. Stun, sleep, fear, irritation, blind, destroy undead. Hell yeah. Where are we gonna find that? Holy word. The white wizard is basically a cleric. Remove curse, which I just... removes a curse... oh, from an object. Oh, maybe so you can use it normally? So, like, it has... I don't know. Does it permanently remove a curse? Like, if you have a good... and if you have, like, something that grants you, you know... 10 extra to your armor class. Your AC, or whatever they call it here. But also... you know... decreases your charisma by 40. Can we remove the decreased charisma and keep the AC boost? I wonder. And we also get food, which is going to be very tedious if we do that, because it takes 20 points just to cast it. That's one food ration. Okay, so it'll give us... I guess it depends on how many people in your group. Yeah, I guess it'll give us 6 rations every time we cast it. But anyway, that's that. She knows this stuff now. Oh, I took the hat off. I'm trying to get my cursor back in the window here. And then Trazric knows... now he knows Tornado. There's the magic arrows, which you already had. Don't use. Storm. And what's the other one we had? Oh, Ice Ball. Now, let's get back to this. Ice Ball does the same as Fireball, right? Ice Ball... oh no, it's even better than Fireball. 8 to 16 damage instead of 4 to 8. But of course... you see, it's double the magic point cost, the mana cost of Fireball. And... what else we have? Tornado is freaking awesome. Look at that. 32 to 64 damage. Really nice. And what was the other one? Storm. 16 to 32. So, that's nice. So, it's going to use up his spell points like crazy, his mana, but crazy, but it's nice. And that's where we currently are. We're going to try to... I've been doing all that off-screen because it's very tedious, especially with my own Amethyst character. It's, he fails and fails and fails, and it's the only time I'm going to save scum, guys, is doing that, because it's ridiculous. It's the old style, the old school way of doing it. Basically, there will be some spells... if I don't do it that way, there might be some spells I never get to use, because... we just won't find it again. Or we'll fail every time, and... wow, that's... we tried to, you know... memorize Remove Curse. I did manage to find 4 scrolls of Remove Curse in the game. And, because I'm sure some aren't sold, it's just an example. And, for all I know, Remove Curse might indeed be sold. It's just an example. But say I only find 4 of them and I fail every time, we will never know. Remove Curse. And I don't want to have that kind of experience. Sorry. So we're going to try to have to... she has Weapons Power 2, I believe. We're going to try to have her memorize that. She's pretty good at memorizing. So as you can see, Anti-Magic goes up. I'm still not sure what this is Clairvoyance is all about. And then we have Invisibility, Magic Sphere. Covers the 6 previous spells each at level 3. So I guess we cast that. Do they mean literally the 6 previous spells, like Invisibility and 1, 2, 3, and Clairvoyance 1, 2, 3? I don't know. Probably not. Covers the 6 previous spells each. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, notice he did that. It is... Okay, so this is not in alphabetical order. So if we cast Magic Sphere, it gives us Light 3, I'm guessing, I think this is what it is, Light 3, Armor Protection 3, Weapons Power 3, Anti-Magic 3, and Clairvoyance 3, and Invisibility 3. I'm guessing that's what that means. Magic Compass I don't need, we have a compass already, I guess that's before you find the actual compass. Identification we've been using, Levitation, which is spelled correctly here, she has that. Haste, she has. I haven't seen the age increase. Mass haste, we don't have that. Teleport, moves the party in direction chosen. X-ray vision allows you to see through walls. So we don't have too much more for her to learn, just basically improved versions of everything. So I just wanna... Because I'm gonna move in a direction... Here we go. I click it to get rid of the other cursor. So let's save. For all I know, I already saved. Set here. Weird how you go into camp, but you're not really camping, so... We're gonna try to have her learn Weapons Power 2. We manage a spell, and the skull fades to dust. Hurry! Because she's pretty good at memorizing spells. She is... Read Magic Skull, 65%. So now, we have Weapons Power 2. So we're going to stop using Weapons Power 1. So now we can go back to Twin Lake. Let's wait till daytime. Actually, hold on one second. Map back up. I'm pretty sure I know where we are. Yeah, we just gotta follow the top of the forest here and then come down south. Way. Ta-da! Now this is the one... There is the shop. So I already have silk. Off-screen, I gave him all the items. So he'll sell them. So he has the highest charisma for maximum efficiency. Beam of Fire. That's a cheapo spell. Light 2, two of them. Magic Arrows, nice, 191 gold. Sleep, 57. Water Hole, 38. Mud Catapult, 57. Transigrade knows those spells. Gives us almost another 400 gold. So we have just a little over 2600. Sweet! So I believe we're done with everything. We don't need to be buying anything else. Now he... Unfortunately, Twin Lake does not sell these crossbow bolts. So I'll probably just heal Gribban. If he's really damaged, I'll give him some healing potions. Keep him in the fight. Because my healing spells don't seem to be keeping up. He just gets bashed pretty quickly. Just making sure there's nothing else I want to sell before I continue on. We got a lot of potions, which is good. We are well stocked for this adventure. Trazric has plenty with sling stones, silk, has plenty of arrows. We have a couple Drelbin herbs in case I get stunned. You can unstun me. So I can unstun other people or continue on with whatever else I'm doing. And yeah. Then we will be good indeed. Okay, so next episode, we'll be heading east of here, or north to get out of this, around this lake. Yeah, it's basically, I want to see, actually. You guys might enjoy seeing the mine. I know it doesn't show up that well, but let's increase this. It doesn't show up that well on my, because I don't have 1080p on my videos, because it's not that kind of thing, but this is much better. See, we are here. You are here. And so we have to either get around the side here or go around here. Dwarf Mines is in here. Looks like there might be a path through here. That would help. Near a river. So this is our next destination. To go find the Dwarven Crown. And then we return back to Donner's Mine. And he said he will pry the Amberstar out of the freaking crown. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.